Welcome back to Botany Class. Let's continue the ecological adaptations. Previously, you learned hydrophytes and xerophytes ecological adaptations. Today, you are going to learn mesophytes, epiphytes, and halophytes ecological adaptations. Let's discuss mesophytes, epiphytes, and halophytes today. Previously, you learned hydrophytes and xerophytes. There are different adaptations seen in different types of plants. Mesophytes, epiphytes, and halophytes. What are called mesophytes? The mesophytic plants which lives in moderate environmental conditions. The moderate plants called as mesophytes. So these plants neither grows on neither too wet nor too dry areas. Normal plants, so what you are seeing around us, these plants are called as mesophytes. What are the adaptations? Ecologically, all already you know that there are different adaptations observed in several kinds of plants. So mesophytes also shows various differences. The various adaptations seen morphologically, morphological adaptations, anatomical adaptations, and physiological adaptations. Adaptations. Today we are going to learn three questions. They are adaptations, ecological adaptations seen in mesophytes, epiphytes, and halophytes. There are three questions. Mesophytes, epiphytes, and halophytes. What are the adaptations observed in various plants? First one is mesophyte. So under each category, there are three different adaptations are observed. What are they? Morphological adaptations, anatomical adaptations, and physiological adaptations. So when you learn this question, you can write under three headings: morphological adaptations, anatomical adaptations, and physiological adaptations. Under morphological adaptations, which includes the morphology of a plant, which includes root, stem, and leaf. Root, stem, and leaf. So under this heading, morphological adaptation, you write about, you remember this point, you write about root system. What about the root system? How the root is adapted to adjust the environmental condition regarding this plant. Then stem and the leaf. Anatomical differences, there are anatomically, internally, when you observe the plant under microscope, you take a section and keep it under microscope, it reveals different parts, various parts. What are the differences shows or variations seen among these plants? So there are different parts like cuticle, epidermis, mesophyll, and vascular tissue. So under this heading, anatomical adaptations, you write about cuticle. What about the cuticle in mesophyte? What about the cuticle in epiphyte? What about the cuticles in halophytes? Then epidermis, what about the epidermis? What about mesophyll? What about the vascular tissue? Then finally, physiological adaptations. You know that there are a number of physiological processes which are taking place in the body of plant. So how this physiological processes takes place? So under this, first you remember how to answer this question. because all these questions are point-wise. Point-wise question, you give more importance because when you score full mark, this type of question you have to prefer at the time of examination. So you learn all these points very clear. Let's see one by one. Means of five. Differences, ecological adaptations observed in mesophytes. You know that the mesophytes are the common plants, moderate conditions, which lives or grow in moderate conditions. What are the morphological adaptations? So under this heading, you first you write about this root, stem, and what about the root system. Normally, you know, when the plant grows, the root system produces under the ground. So here is the root. In this mesophytic plants, which possess the root consists of root cap as well as root hair. Here at the end of this, there is a root cap. The root cap is present in this mesophyte plants. Roots possess root cap and root hair. One word or two mark question, which is important. Under root, you mentioned this point, root cap and root hair is present in mesophytes. The stem, you know that the stem is the aerial part of the plant. The stem, which is highly branched. Stem is aerial part and the stem is highly branched. Then, what about the leaf? The leaf, you know, there are different shapes of leaf in the mesophytic plants. Different shapes. This is one shape and this is another shape. So different shapes, various shapes of the plants, which is broad, long leaves are present in mesophytes. Then anatomical differences. The externally morphological characters, which is shows the external characters. What are the observable characters through our eye? So the root and the stem, if you uproot it, we can see the system of the root system, whether it is stem root system or fibrous root system, monocots or dicots, we can differentiate. And the stem as well as leaf. But anatomical adaptations, anatomy, how will you observe this anatomical adaptations? When you take a section and keep it under microscope, because it's made up of number of cells, this is one example. These cells we couldn't see through the naked eye, so keep it under microscope and observe this. So this consists of various parts, or it reveals different parts. They are cuticles. So in mesophytic plants, at first there is a layer called epidermis. Normally there is a protective layer which is called as epidermis. Outer to this, there is a cuticle is present. But in this mesophytic plants, there is a cuticle, the cuticle which is present as moderate, and the epidermis is well developed, which can consist of stomata, the upper epidermis and the lower epidermis, which possess stomata. And in the mesophyll, this mesophyll tissue which is found in the leaf, between this upper and lower epidermis, this is the upper epidermis, and in the lower epidermis, here upper and lower epidermis, in the leaf of mesophytes, this is upper epidermis, this is lower epidermis, and in between this region is known as mesophyll. In mesophytes, this mesophyll is differentiated into two different types of cells, that is, this part which is made up of palisade parenchyma. And another of these cells are made up of spongy parenchyma. So mesophyll tissue is differentiated into palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. So it differentiated. Dorsiventral leaf is differentiated into palisade and
spongy parenchyma.
So under mesophyll, palisade parenchyma as well as spongy parenchyma is present. Then vascular tissue. Vascular tissue which includes xylem and phloem. Xylem and phloem are well developed in mesophytes. So these are the anatomical differences observed in mesophytes. Now what are the physiological adaptations in mesophytes? Physiological functions are normal in mesophytes, and wilting or drooping, this takes place at room temperature. So if there is a scarcity of water, drooping or wilting takes place. These two points you write up under physiological adaptations. So this physiological adaptations you may pick up for 2 mark question, because only 2 points are there. What are the 2 points? First point, this mesophytes, all the physiological functions are normal. What are physiological functions? There are number of physiological functions including respiration, transpiration, photosynthesis and green plants. So these all physiological, normal physiological functions are occur in this mesophytes. And wilting and drooping, if scarcity of water at normal temperature, room temperature, this scarcity can observe in mesophytes. I hope that you understand this question very clear. First you write about morphological adaptation. The question is ecological adaptations seen in mesophytes. First point you write about morphological adaptation, anatomical adaptation, then physiological adaptation. Let's move to the second question, epiphytes. What are epiphytes? Epiphytes are the plants, you know that epiphytes are the plants which grow perched on other plants. What's the meaning? Perched, which needs this support, which requires support on other plants. These are not seen like parasites because it has the ability to synthesize its own food. So photosynthesis process is normal, but only for support it needs another object. Such a plants are comes under the category epiphytes. What are the morphological adaptations? The morphologically the plants are adapted in such a way. Now first morphological adaptation regarding root. The roots in epiphytes are two different types. They are clinging root and aerial root. There are two different types of roots observed in epiphytic plants. Example of epiphytes, you know there are number of orchids as well as money plant. These are comes under epiphytic plants. Orchids, you know, money plant also very common example. These all plants possess two different types of root. Clinging root, the clinging root which helps the plants to fix firmly to the supporting object, either another plant or any other object. So another plant, so it do not takes place food or water from this supporting plant. Clinging roots just for fix the epiphyte strongly or firmly, it needs this clinging root is helps. So function of clinging root which fixes the epiphyte to the supporting plant. Aerial roots, there are aerial roots. These roots are green color roots which just hangs down on the air. So these roots have a special type of spongy tissue known as velamen. So this tissue is very important to absorb the moisture from the atmosphere. So these two types of roots are observed in this epiphytic plants root. Then the stem, most of the stems of epiphytes are succulent in nature. Most of the epiphytes, it develop a pseudo bulb or tubers, bulb or pseudo bulbs, or it produces tubers. tubers and bulbs are produced in the stem, and the leaves are normally less in number. The leaves. And another character is myrmecophily. What's this? Ants live on this plants. Myrmecophilous condition occurs to avoid predators. So this myrmecophily helps the plant to avoid predators. This condition, you give importance to this point. Myrmecophily observed in epiphytes. So these are the morphological adaptations. So first write about morphological adaptations. Then the fruits and the seeds are very small and dispersive by means of insects or wind or birds. That point also you include under morphological adaptations. Anatomical adaptations. Second point, anatomical adaptations. What are the anatomical adaptations? This is the example of tears of aerial root of orchid. So one of the example of epiphytes is orchid showing velamen tissue. So these parts are observed in the anatomy. This is the structure, anatomical structure of the aerial root. Structure of root, orchid root, transverse section. So which possesses multi-layered epidermis. So first point you write about this epidermis. The epidermis is multi-layer. Normally there is a single layer of epidermis, but in orchid there is, or in epiphytes there is a multi-layered epidermis because of the presence of velamen tissue. What's velamen? This is two more question, very important. What's this? It's a special kind of tissue which helps, this is a special type of spongy tissue, helps to absorb water from the moisture. So this velamen is a multi-layered epidermis. It's found in most of the epiphytes or this most of the epiphytic plants. So that this epidermal part is multi-layered. There are many layers of epidermis, and there is a thick cuticle present. After to this epidermis, there is a thick cuticle. Inner to this velamen tissue, there is a layer. This layer is called as exodermis. Inner to this epidermis, epidermis is multi-layered. Inner to this, there is a layer of cell called exodermis. Beneath this exodermis, there are number of parenchymatous cells. So this cortex region, this region is known as cortex. Cortex is made up of number of parenchymatous cells to store the food materials. So this cortex region. Now inner to this cortex, there is an endodermis. You know that endodermis, inside pericycle there is a layer. This is outer layer is endodermis. Inner there is a single layer of barrel shaped parenchymatous cell is there, called pericycle. And inner to this, the xylem and phloem are arranged alternately. These are the xylem vessels, these are the phloem. So this is vascular tissue alternatively which arrange, and conjunctive tissue, the xylem and phloem connected by conjunctive tissue. Inside there is a pit, and the xylem vessel, there are two different types. They are metaxylem and protoxylem. The earlier form xylem is called as protoxylem. The later form xylem or the mature xylem is called as metaxylem. So this is the anatomical adaptations observed in epiphytic plants. Now what are the physiological adaptations? Physiological adaptations, you give importance to this tissue, velamen tissue. Velamen tissue is the is help the plant to absorb water. What's the velamen? It's a spongy tissue which helps to absorb water from the moisture. That is the physiological function of epiphytes. Hope that you understand this question. Morphological adaptation, anatomical adaptation, as well as physiological adaptation. Now let's move to the next one, halophytes. Now there is another type of plants which is called halophytes. What are called halophytes? Halophytes are the plants which grows on the soil which is rich in salt concentration. Usually this type of plants are seen near to the coastal areas, near to the seashore or in the estuaries. Estuaries are the areas which enclosed by coastal water bodies where the fresh water enters from rivers or streams. So this type of water, this area, there is a different environmental conditions. So this area, the salt water, salt concentration is high in the soil and the ocean water is mixed with the fresh water. The ocean water as well as the fresh water mixes together. So salt content is present in the water. The plants which never absorb directly the salt water. So there is a physiological functions require to filter the salt water. So this, in this condition, the halophytes are grown. So such area, the plants are named as mangroves. Mangrove forest, or they are called as mangroves. The examples are Rhizophora and Abyssinia are the examples of this plant, mangrove plants. The example of mangrove plants are Rhizophora and Abyssinia, or they are called as halophytes. So halophyte plants which grow in the soil where which is rich in high salt condition. What are the morphological adaptations? So in this plants, the Abyssinia or Rhizophora, here in addition to the normal, so there are different types of plants. There are herbaceous plants or bushy plants. In tropical area and temperate regions, there are different, either bushy plants or herbaceous plants can be observed. And the root system, in addition to the normal root system, there are number of stilt root. Stilt root is observed. Stilt root is observed in addition to the normal root, as well as there is a root called breathing root. Breathing root. These breathing roots are otherwise called nematophores. Nematophore or breathing root. What's this root? Breathing root or nematophore? Here there is a normal root. Normal root which is present. In addition to this normal root, there are some aerial roots. Aerial roots develops. There are some roots which grows negatively geotrophic. Normal root which grows towards positively geotrophic. It grows towards the soil. Positively geotrophic. The nature of the root is positively geotrophic, negatively phototrophic. But these are the special types of roots called nematophores. This is called as nematophore. They are the special kind of root which grows negatively geotrophic and it possesses a nematode. These are nematode. These nematodes present in nematophore. So they are the pores observed in this. These roots are called as breathing roots. The name of this root is breathing root. This is the special feature occur in this halophytes. So one of the special feature occurs in halophytes are breathing roots. Another one, viviparous condition. Viviparous mode of seed germination. Viviparous seed germination. So these two are very important in halophytes. In halophytes, there are breathing roots and viviparous seed germination. So viviparous seed germination. This viviparous seed germination is inside the fruit the seed germinate. Because when the seed falls down in the mud, here it is salty nature and poor aeration is very poor. So the seed may not germinate. So within the plant, within the fruit itself, here is the twig, here leaves, these are the leaves, and the fruit is present here. This is the fruit. So it starts to germinate within the fruit. The seeds start to germinate within the fruit, and after germinating it falls down. It falls down in the mud. After germinating within the fruit, the seed germinate. After germinating it falls down. As soon as it falls down in the mud, it immediately it grows. It develops the stem, the root stem as well as remaining parts. Radical already developed within the fruit itself. So this type of seed germination is called as viviparous. So viviparous seed germination. And so this is the morphological adaptations. Then anatomical adaptations. So what are the anatomical adaptations? So anatomically, the epidermal layers consist of thick cuticle and star-shaped scleroids are present. So star-shaped scleroids and H-shaped thickened spicules also present. Scleroids and spicules. Anatomical adaptations, you mentioned these two points, scleroids and spicules. The scleroids are otherwise called stone cells. Stone cells are present, they are star-shaped stone cells, scleroids. Scleroids are star-shaped and the spicules. Spicules are H-shaped spicules are present. Then physiological adaptation, important point of physiological adaptation is viviparous in condition. Viviparous, what's meant by viviparous? The seed germinates within the fruit. After germinating, it falls down and develops normally. So these are the adaptations observed in halophytes. So remember, what are the questions you learned today? Mesophyte, morphology, the ecological adaptations observed in mesophyte, epiphyte and halophytes. Each question write under three headings: morphological adaptations, anatomical adaptations and ecological adaptations. Thank you.